While the unknown beyond our planet can be extremely intriguing, there's still so much we don't know about just below our surface. Many mysteries still hide under the water that dominates our planet. In this Sci-Five, we list off 5 amazing discoveries from underwater. Number 5, the lost city of Heracleion, also known as Thonis. Heracleion was an 8th century ancient Egyptian religion and trade hub located near the mouth of the Nile. The city was also home to the temple where Cleopatra was inaugurated. As it came prior to the city of Alexandria, it served as the original point of entry for Egypt. Ancient Egyptians referred to the city as Thonis. According to the Greek historian Herodotus, this is where the famous Greek hero Hercules first stepped foot onto Egypt, and Helen of Troy visited to see her lover Paris before the Trojan War began. The city is also said to be home of the Temple of Hercules. For a long time, the city seemed no more than Greek mythology, until 2000 when it was discovered by the European Institute for Underwater Archaeology, hidden beneath the Mediterranean Sea and buried in sand. Its discovery came from a 4-year geophysical survey headed by underwater archaeologist Dr. Frank Gaggio. The ruins of the lost city were found just 30 feet under the surface of the sea in Abukir Bay near Alexandria. It went under a 13-year excavation period, which helped confirm that it was indeed Heracleion. Besides recovering artifacts, archaeologists also used the survey data to construct a computer model of what the city may have looked like. Over 60 ancient shipwrecks and more than 700 anchors have been discovered at the site. Other items recovered include gold coins, weights from Athens, which have never before been found at an Egyptian site, and giant tablets inscribed in ancient Greek and Egyptian. As well, researchers found 16-foot stone sculptures and limestone sarcophagi that may have contained mummified animals. One mystery about this city still prevails. Why did it sink? Frank Gaggio's team believes it may have been caused by the city building large structures on waterlogged clay and sand soil, which would have caused the city to sink in the case of an earthquake. But no one really knows for sure how the once famed entrance to Egypt ended up below the Mediterranean Sea. Number 4, Bimini Road. Despite often being referred to as a road, there is no conclusive evidence to show exactly what it was, and the stone structure is also thought to have been a wall, pier, breakwater, or another man-made structure. The stone formations stretch for about 1/2 mile long, with a hook at one end. The stones can measure up to 13 feet across, and some scientists think at one point they all connected to form one large structure. In December of 1968, divers Joseph Manson Valentine, Jax Mayle, and Robert Angove came across an extensive amount of pavement, or a paved road, which was later found to be various sizes of rounded stones. This attracted the attention of many different kinds of scientists, including archaeologists, geologists, and marine engineers. It was soon after discovered that there was another formation of the same kind parallel to the original structure closer to the shore. The structure is located just 20 feet below the surface off the coast of North Bimini Island in the Bahamas, and is often linked to the lost city of Atlantis. The date of the stones found supposedly match Plato's description of Atlantis, which would have been about 600 BC. Other points in favor of this theory are that Bimini Road is under the Atlantic Ocean, and the scale of the stones match the structures described by Plato. Skeptics dispute this theory due to the distance the island would have been to Athens. As well, some geologists say the samples drilled from the rock prove it is a natural phenomenon. Another curious fact about Bimini Road is that an American mystic named Edgar Cayce made a prediction in 1938 about its discovery. He said, "A portion of the temple may yet be discovered under the slime of ages and seawater near Bimini. Expect it to be in 68 or 69, not so far away." The Bimini Road was discovered in 1968, and Cayce said it was the rising of Atlantis. However, as with most mystics, Edgar had a lot of controversy around his work, with many inaccurate and bizarre claims. Could this have been a lucky guess? What do you think? Number 3. The Inagae Monument. In 1995, off the southern coast of the Japanese island Inagae, a diver accidentally stumbled upon a very peculiar arrangement of large stone blocks. Many of the blocks had perfect right-angle joins, carvings, and what appeared to be paved streets, crossroads, and plazas. There are also 2 large megaliths that appear to have been placed there. They have straight edges and square corners, but are said to move often due to sea currents. While some claim the formations are purely caused by natural phenomenon, retired professor of science from a university in Japan, Masaki Kimura, believes these structures were in fact man-made. Kimura, who also holds a doctorate in marine geology, says there are several pieces of evidence that prove these are not caused by nature. He claims two round holes on the edges of the triangle pool feature and a straight row of smaller holes have been interpreted as a failed attempt to split off a section of the rock by means of wedges. Kimura also says he has identified traces of animal drawings and people engraved into the rocks, as well as a character from the Kaida script. Others have claimed this could be proof of remnants of the mythical lost continent of Mu. Some believe several ancient civilizations, such as those of Egypt and Mesoamerica, were created by refugees from Mu. However, this is another heavily debated concept. Number 2. Stonehenge-like structure in Lake Michigan. While searching for old shipwrecks lost below the surface of Lake Michigan, archaeologists found something much more unique than they were expecting. In 2007, while using sonar technology, they spotted out very odd structures about 40 feet below the lake's Grand Traverse Bay. Mark Hawley, a professor of underwater archaeology at Northwestern Michigan University College, and his colleague Brian Abbott found the site hiding. They found a series of stones standing in a Stonehenge-like fashion, as well as a boulder with the prehistoric carving of a mastodon. By analyzing geographical history, they found out the site would have been a tundra when hunter-gatherer humans claimed the land 6 to 9,000 years ago. It wouldn't be too far-fetched to attribute the stones to the peoples of the past, as other stone circles like this have been found at the bottom of Great Lakes. When diving to the site, Mark Hawley described it as incredibly spooky. He said, "The whole site is spooky in a way. When you're swimming through a long line of stones and the rest of the lake bed is featureless, it's just spooky." Unfortunately for the curious, but fortunate for the land, most divers will not get to experience this feeling as the site's exact location is kept a secret in order to appease the Grand Traverse Bay's native community, who want to preserve the discovery. And number 1, Lion City. This one technically wasn't discovered, but rather purposely placed and abandoned to make way for an artificial lake. The Lion City, which is also known as Shai Chang, is an ancient city hiding about 40 meters below the water in Thousand Island Lake, China. The discovery that makes this case truly interesting is that despite over half a century underwater, the city has been preserved completely intact. The city dates back to about 200 AD and was once the center for politics and economics in the province of Zhejiang. It was in 1959 that the Chinese government made the decision to turn the land that the city was built on into a man-made lake in order to create a new hydroelectric power station. After the dam was built, the city slowly began to flood until completely being covered by incoming water. The lake now covers 573 kilometers squared and is home to more than 1,000 large islands and thousands more small ones. The lake hid Lion City for 53 years, until a curious diver in charge of local tourism decided to pay a visit to the forgotten city. He found that due to the city being protected from the natural elements, it was perfectly preserved and the lake was creating a time capsule. Temples, memorial arches, paved roads, and houses complete with wooden beams and stairs can be found under the water. Luckily for the curious, this site has been opened as a dive spot by the local tourist office. Thanks for checking out this Sci-Five. If you liked it, be sure to like and comment, and check out my last video, 5 Fascinating Secret Government Science Projects. Also, don't forget to subscribe for more videos on all things science and science fiction.